Morning students,
In geometric progression we will study next geometric mean and geometric mean terms. You remember the thing in AP, arithmetic mean and arithmetic mean terms, we saw two things. Now we will study geometric mean and geometric mean terms. What is the meaning of geometric mean? Look at it. When A, capital G and B are in GP, only three terms I am taking in GP, then middle term will be geometric mean of first and last. Only three terms are in GP, then middle term will be the geometric mean of first and last. So how we can find the capital G? Follow the rule of the GP, that second term upon first term is always equal to third term upon second term. So do the cross multiply, g into g, g inverse is equal to ab, and one can easily find the value of g is equal to plus minus over root ab. According to the mathematical concept, it is only the geometric mean of a and b, but in further questions sometimes minus ignored, only plus is taken. So whenever I ask you what is the geometric mean of AB, you reply only root over root AB. If one is saying plus and minus, it is still correct. But in mathematical concept or lots of question, only plus is taken. So we make a habit to speak or write geometric mean of AB is only positive over root AB. Keep in mind. Suppose you want to find the geometric mean. Suppose you have a question, I think you may have a question in the book. It is not so, no matter at all. Suppose you want to find the geometric mean of 2 and 8. That's simple. So definitely it is your A, it is your B, and geometric mean is equal to, you can say AB. You also can take plus and minus, it is still correct. I am taking only one option, positive option. So your answer is 2 into 8, A into B, your answer 16, meaning 4. So geometric mean of 2 and 8 is 4. That is simple. So student, this was a geometric mean. It means that between two terms we have a single term, so that all terms are in GP. Now next I'll tell you geometric mean terms. Means also called geometric means. It means that between A and B we have a sum terms. Sum. When single term exists, it is called geometric mean. But more than one terms, if they exist, it is called geometric mean terms. So suppose we that these are n terms. These are n terms or n mean terms between A and B. Very important thing that first term is A, last term is, we can say L, or definitely it is also called TN. You should remember last term and TN are always same in EP as well as in GP. Last term and TN are same. So okay, last term is a B or TN is equal to B. Number of terms, let me write this out. Last term is B. Number of terms, very important thing. Mean terms are taken n. Sometimes students speak that number of terms are n, but it is false, because actually between them we have a number of terms n, but first and last are already there. So including a and b and n, we have a n plus 2 terms. You know, 1, 2, and between them we have a n, total n plus 2 terms. So this is first term, this is last term, this is number of terms. What we will do? We will find the value of ratio. Ratio. I tell you how it is so. You go with the formula L equal to AR N minus 1. This is a formula of TN, N term. So it is also called last term. So last term is B, first term is A, small r I don't know. I intentionally took here capital N because it is number of terms, small n I cannot take because it has come in other sense. Small n is number of mean terms, but capital N are number of terms. So number of terms here, it is n plus 2 minus 1. So overall B, upon A, that A I transferred, r to the power n plus 1, and lastly I would find small r, meaning I will transfer to the power n plus 1, which will actually transfer in the left side, as I am writing here for u b upon A to the power, it gets reciprocal, 1 upon n plus 1, b upon A to the power 1 upon n plus 1, and this is one of the important formula you have obtained, that whenever you want to find the geometric mean terms, you will use a formula r equal to b upon a to the power 1 upon n plus 1. This will be given, number of mean terms as you want to find, it will be also given. So you all put the value there and get your r, and after finding the r, this after a, this will be your first geometric mean term. So first geometric mean term is called g1, and one should know that after a it will be ar, this is very simple. You know, I taught you yesterday the symbolic form of gp, that a, then ar, then ar square, and so on. So this is first term a, and this is first mean term. Keep in mind, it is second term for GP, but it is for mean term, it is first mean term, which is called G1. Second mean term will be G2, and that is AR square. So now make a habit and trick in your mind that whenever you want to find G2, you will use a square. When similarly, one can understand that you will find G3, third mean term, AR3. Fourth mean term AR4, meaning as many mean terms or which mean terms you want to find, the power will be same. But in case of terms, you know that yesterday I taught you T2, T3, T4, Tn is equal to ARn minus 1, that is different. T5 you want to find, you want to write AR. T4 you want to find, it is AR3. This and this are different. This is mean terms and this is term. So keep and defer in your mind the knowledge. Now I am telling you one of the question which depends on that particular concept. Example number 17 I have, and the question says insert 3 means or numbers between 1 and 256 so that resulting sequence R and G P. So one can think very simple this in a very simple way, that insert 3 mean terms between 1 and 256 so that they form a G P. When they all form a G P, it means they are none else but these are the geometric mean terms, because the resulting sequence is G P. So these called geometric mean terms. So can we say that it is A equal to 1? It is B. And what is N? How many mean terms you want to find out? 3. So this time keep remember, small n is your number of mean terms. And now you should not go with the number of terms, small a, first term, last term, and so on, because you already have proved the concept R equal to. So use the trivium formula. We know that R equal to B upon A to the power 1 upon N plus 1. Put a value. What is B? 256. What is A? 1. 1 upon N plus 1. So N was 3. 3 plus 1, 4. So ultimately 256 can be written 4 to the power 4. You know 4 to the power 4 is a 256. And whole power 1 by 4. Both 4 cancel. So your answer is 4. Meaning you have got the small r. And when after finding the small r, you want to find 3 mean terms, guys, you follow the formula G1, G2 and G3. 3 mean terms they are. So, first mean term G1 is equal to AR, that will be formula use. So, A is 1, R is a 4, 4 1s are 4, G2 is AR square, meaning 1 into 4 to the power 2. It's 16, when G3 is AR cube, that 1 into 4 to the power 3 is a 64. So these are 3 geometric mean terms we have found between 1 and 256. That is simple method now.
Okay, let me write this. Now let me take one more example. Now concept already I have taught you of the particular exercise, upcoming exercise. Now see the type of question. Example number 18. Good question it is. Question says, if arithmetic mean and geometric mean of two positive numbers a and b are 10 and 8, find the numbers. Simple question this is. Given geometric mean of a and b is geometric mean of a and b is 8 and arithmetic mean of a and b is 10. We want to find numbers. Mean we want to find a and b. We want to find the numbers whom we want to find a and b. Now according to question, I will go with solution. Look at arithmetic mean of a and b. We know arithmetic mean of a and b. We know it is a plus b by 2. We talk about here the mean, not mean terms. So arithmetic mean of a and b is a plus b by 2, which is given 10. A plus b by 2, which is given 10. So 2 into 10, 20. We have got one equation in a and b. You want to find a and b, guys. Now geometric mean of a and b, I taught you it is usually taken positive sign. I taught you that usually taken positive sign. And geometric mean of a and b is 8, is equal to over root a b. Take squaring both sides, a b equal to 64. So this is your second equation. So students, now how to find a and b? You only merge them. You only merge them. So how we can merge? We can take a value of any value like b. So b equal to 20 minus a, you put here. Meaning you just want to merge them by anyhow. So by one, I'll write after this a into instead of b, I will write 20 minus a. You know, 20 minus a is equal to, this is 64. Now I'll multiply. 20a minus a square equal to 64. Now I do transfer each and everything. It's gonna be a square minus 20a plus 64 is equal to 0. This is simple now. Now we can split or we can use a formula method. I split only. A square minus 16a minus 4a. 16 4 64. 16 4 20. That's simple. Now take out a common. A minus 16. Take out 4 common. So we have a 16 here. So we take a minus 16 common. So we have a number a equal to 4 and 16. So we have two possible ways, a equal to 4 and b a equal to 16. One can simply understand when a will be 4, when a will be 4, b will be 16. Or when a will be 16, b will be 4. So simple. When a equal to 4, then b will be 16, and when a will be 16, b will be 4. So please come out from the all these kind of aspects and write only numbers, no matter which is a and which is b. Numbers are 4 and 16, it is good enough to tell, no matter which is a and which is b. So this is a question, simple question it was. So student, these were all the examples. Now it's time, your time to go. You have a good 32 questions. The next exercise is out of syllabus. According to the new syllabus, the 9.4 is out of syllabus. So it's the last one. Now you do from your side, and still doubt, you can ask me. Tomorrow we'll look some more question which may come in exam. Thank you.